zombie slogging, closing in. Glassy eyed with decayed skin. Trudging slow with reaching arms. All prepared to do you harm. On this night, in historically hip downtown Issaquah, the zombies come alive.
Brains!
But this year is different. In person is dead. Just like the zombies, with holes in their heads. So join us now for this yearly walk. Although it's virtual, it will still be a shock.
Welcome to the Issaquah Zombie Walk, home edition. We're streaming to you this year with hopes of being back together again, dancing on the steps of City Hall in 2021. So once a year when the zombies invade Issaquah and make their way to City Hall, not only do the hundreds of people that attend enjoy it, but the merchants love it.
I'm Jared.
We are the Cattle Dog Cookie Company.
Hi, my name is Claude Blumensway.
Hi, I'm Eric Pascal.
My name is Bartan.
Hi, I'm Susie from Las Margaritas.
Hi, I'm Ken from Jack's Grill.
And I love.
We love.
I love.
We love.
Zombie walk.
The Issaquah Zombie Walk.
As we begin Issaquah Zombie Walk Home Edition, and let's hear how it all began with founder Tom.
Hi, I'm Tom, the founder of Issaquah Zombie Walk and Zombie Fest.
What turned out to be just a few families enjoying Front Street
has morphed into hundreds of families coming down here and having a great time.
It's now one of the city's largest events.
Join us as we look back at previous year's videos.
Hi, I'm Ken from Jack's Grill and L42 Cantina down here on Front Street, where we have the beautiful outdoor streetery, thanks to the Downtown Issaquah Association. We've been in Issaquah for a long time, serving a lot of meals, and we're down here to try to take care of everybody we can. We're serving steak at Jack's, and we're serving Mexican food at L42 Cantina, and we hope that you all come down and join us while the weather holds out for the streetery, sit outside or indoors where we've got our restaurant nice and spaced and safe, and you can come in and enjoy a meal indoors as well.
My name is Bartan, and I'm owning the Chicago Pastrami Restaurant in the heart of Issaquah City. So we have in our restaurant the American, and we have the Mediterranean. We have also the Armenian style food. Basically, our foods are homemade. Come to our restaurant to get it and we'll enjoy it, really enjoy it.
With 2020 being a home edition for most, here's some zombie activities you can do at home.
Hey, I'm Katrina and I'm gonna show you some home edition goodies that you can do with your little zombies. We've got a party like a zombie kit that we're sending. The kids are over here on Zoom with their friends. We're not letting the pandemic get in the way of having a little bit of fun. We've sent a little party kit to each one of their friends.
Everybody got some bingo things, some paintbrushes for painting rocks, and a joke thing, a list of zombie jokes. And everybody got a kit to make some zombie slime, and some snacks and some gloves.
With a little graveyard cupcake and a little beverage potion here, potent potion. They've also got some games and activities they're playing with their friends over here. We sent a little kit to them, play bingo, and they have a little scavenger hunt. And they're even sharing some undead humor. And over here on the table, we've got some creepy canning that we've put together just for some party decorations. Our eyeballs are lychee fruit. The ears are dragon fruit, and we've got some little carved fingers in the last jar there. And we've also got a unicorn horn made out of a bamboo shoot. All right, so over here we've got some goodies for you to try at home with your little ones during our Zombie Walk Home Edition. We've got some graveyard goodies here. We've got little cupcakes with little dirt on top with a little zombie hand reaching out to grab you. We've got some pumpkin pretzels over here. And we've got our food with feelings. We've got some vampire donuts and some little monster cookies over here. And over here we've got some a mummy wrap. It's a lovely pastry with a little bloody center made of strawberry jam. Over here we've got some eyeball eggs for you to enjoy. And no zombie party would be complete without some brains. So we'll have her make some slime over here for us. Okay, do you wanna go ahead and pour the glue in your bowl? And then we're gonna mix a quarter teaspoon of baking soda in with this 4 ounces of glue. Go ahead and mix that until it's in there pretty good. And at this point, we can also add a couple drops of food coloring if we want to really make it some zombie sludge. Okay, so mix that together really well. And we'll add a little dollop of lotion to make it a little bit softer. And keep mixing really well. It's looking good and zombie-like.
And now for the activator.
And for our activator, we're using contact solution. And you just want to put it in one drop at a time. And it comes together quickly. So just put a few drops and slowly start stirring.
And then you can see it starts to turn into some slime.
It's getting good and sticky. Mm-hmm.
And when it's ready, I can take it out and start kneading it so that it gets to a good texture.
You want to get your hands in that zombie slime?
Yeah. Oh wow, this is sticky.
our zombie hands out front. Our undead paper craft chair. We've got a zombie brain made out of a paper plate and some pipe cleaners. And then we've got some brain jelly soap over here. Some nice squishy gooey zombie soap. And how about our ghoulish games over here? Kylie, do you want to show off your ghoulish games? Play a little pumpkin bowling? Oh, so close. Do you want to tell them how you made that?
So these are actually lemonade bottles that we painted orange.
And how did you prepare the bottles?
So we peeled off the labels.
You peeled off the labels and then you just painted with some acrylic paint? Mm-hmm. You made some awesome pumpkin bowling pins.
Yeah.
That's great. And you're using pumpkins for balls. Mm-hmm. And then what do we have over here, Kylie?
Here we have
a zombie brain toss. Awesome. Do you want to pick up the little brains and show us what it can do?
Okay.
Can you... Go ahead and grab one. Doing a zombie can brain toss here. Good try.
Today, I am going to make a monster pop. Okay, so first, I'm going to take a piece of tissue paper and wrap it around here. And then I'm going to cut off a little bit of this to tie it around to keep the tissue paper in place. And then I'm gonna get some googly eyes and then just glue them on there. You can make this a three-eyed monster. And then you could also turn it into a spider or one-eyed monster or even a pumpkin. They're really easy to make and don't require a lot of materials. Plus, they're delicious for afterward.
Hi, I'm Susie from Las Margaritas, a family-owned restaurant that's been around for about 20 years. We have outside seating and we love the zombie walk.
I'm Eric Pascal. I'm the owner of Levitate Gastro Pub here in wonderful old town Issaquah. In a fun time of the year right now, coming into the fall of 2020. It's just kind of a crazy year, but we're plowing through, getting through this, and we're excited for the upcoming zombie walk, the virtual one. It's always been a highlight of our fall program to create some good drinks for the zombie walk, and so we're excited to support it virtually this year.
Issaquah Zombie Walk is not just about costumes and makeup, it's about dancing. And as those zombies make their way down Front Street to City Hall, they dance. Here with the help of the Glass House Dancers are the steps to Thriller and Time Warp.
Hi, my name is Zena. I'm going to be teaching you how to dance the Thriller today. So the Thriller is a really easy dance to learn. There's only two main things I want to say before we get started. One, since it is a very simple dance, if you have the movement down, go ahead and add your own like funky zombiness to it, like claw hands, weird feet. You can make it your own in that kind of creepy sense. And number two, I'm gonna move through this pretty quickly. You can always press rewind, go back and watch a section again to make sure you have it. So Thriller starts on the floor. You get in some weird position, laying down as creepy as you want. You can stick an arm up, you can do whatever you want. And you hold for a really, really long time until you hear the beat come in. When the beat comes in, you have, again, a really long time to creepily find a way to stand up. You do have quite a while, so you can stay on the floor for a bit, move around, crawl around before you stand up. And then the music kind of does a... That's when you need to be up. Your arms go up in the sky, Thriller Night. So we're gonna listen to the music once, just to get that in your bodies. That should be really simple. It's just hearing the correct beats to start on, so. Okay, and that is the intro to Thriller. The next part is also very easy. It is basically just walks. So we have four slow walks to the front, followed by four slow walks to the back. This is when you can start to make things creepy on your own, because we don't want to just walk. So you step one, two, three, four, back. One, two, three, four. Always leading with your right foot. You do it again. Front, two, three, four, and back. Two, three, four. Then the walks get slightly more advanced, but they're still just walks. You walk twice as fast, and your head hits your right shoulder on the counts 1, 5, and 7. In music, there's an 8 count, so you have to count to the beat. 1, 5, and 7, your head hits your shoulder. So it should look something like this. Walk 1, hit 5, 7, walk back 1, hit 5, and 7. And those are the easy beginning walks. So I'm gonna add on a little bit more before we try that with music, since the walks are pretty basic. If you need to watch that again, just go ahead and rewind the video now. After you do the walks, you turn and face the side. Your arms go out into an L. We're facing left. You have claw hands, you're facing an L. You go shake, shake, step together, head goes down. Again, shake, shake, step together, head down. After that, you take your claws and you circle, circle, switch sides, circle, circle. With my feet, I'm doing a little step together step while I'm doing my circle arms. So let's try all of that with music from where we did our Thriller Night situation. One, two. To the front. To the back. Inside, shake, shake, head down. Shake, shake, head down. Circle, circle, switch, circle, circle. Okay, and that is the first part of Thriller. We're gonna move on a little bit more. After you do your circles, you go step, step. You bevel or like pop your front heel. Your head goes back. You do a couple of jumps and you land in this squat position with your head down. Then you hit your head up. So that one more time, your foot is up in a bevel if you're a dancer. Head up, jump, jump, squat, head. From there, you like grab your Michael Jackson waistband, you have grab your claw, you lift one, two, three, four, popping your hip with that. Your feet come into parallel, you bring them together. Plie, clap, up. You shimmy to the left, you can use your shoulders or like Reagan does, her head side to side. I can't do that though, so shimmy. Then you look. Shoulders, plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp and shoulders and head. My bad, I got that the wrong way around. So after you do the shimmy, stomp your foot, shoulders up, look the way you're going. That one more time. After we do the up, down, 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 head, you lift one, two, three, and four. Plie, clap, up, shimmy, 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 stomp and shoulders and head. Other way. Plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp, and shoulders, and head. We're gonna try that all that with the music from the 1, 5, 7 walks. 5, 7, back, 1, 5, 7, shake and shake, head down, shake and shake, head down, circle, circle, switch, circle, circle, step up, jump, jump, squat, head, lift, 2, 3, 4, plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp and shoulder and head, stomp and shoulder and head. And that is the first chorus. So this is where the iconic claw hands come in. If you are still confused, rewind, go back, we're gonna move on. So you take your claws, you shake right, right, right,
then you do this like awkward point situation. Right hand reaches up, your left leg points to the ground. One, two, three, up. One, two, three, lift. Then the walks, switch, swing, 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 swing. It's pretty basic. It's just walking with zombie arms. After that, you jump, your arm circle to the ground. You pull your arm up like you're pulling a chainsaw, and then you start to kind of shuffle to the back. So we will do that all one more time from the first chorus. You go. One, two, three, lift, four. Swing, 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 pick up. Walk, two, three. Swing, swing, swing. Walk, walk, walk. Swing, swing. Jump, circle, chainsaw arm. Scooch around to the back. Okay, that with the music. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, point. Swing, up, walk. Swing, swing, swing. Swing, swing. Arms, roller. Okay, now adding on to those walks, that is the first chorus. If you messed it up or you need an extra practice, go back and do it again. That chorus does come in later, so it's important you have it strong. After you walk back, you look behind you on 7, and then you do 4 more walks to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you quickly turn around over your right shoulder, and we go back to walking. This one is a slightly different pattern. You step right, left, right, left, right. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Then you go back. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. After those walks, it repeats from the beginning. So you go back to this bevel, look up, jump, jump, squat, head, lift. 1, 2, 3, 4. Plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp and shoulder and head. Plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp and shoulder and head. From here, it is slightly different. You jump your feet out wide. You take your right hand, swing, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can snap, I physically can't. On 7, you jump, face the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Jump, face the front. So every time you're jumping towards your right shoulder. After we jump and face the front, you do crazy circle arms in kind of whatever way you want. You like go super, super crazy, you hit, hold. Then you kind of jerk down, 1, 2, 3. So again, you go crazy, 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 hit. 1, 2, 3. Then we do what my old dance teacher called crazy lady hailing a taxi. 1, 2, 3, 4. Grab to the right. Punch, punch, punch to the left. Drop down, face front. And then that is the second chorus. So we're gonna do that whole part with music from the end of the first chorus. Okay, we're moving on to the second chorus. This one is very different from the first chorus. The way me and Miss Reagan like to teach this is you have to think head, shoulders, knees, and toes, which is kind of funny. So you're down. On Thriller, you step up, step, step up. Then you look head, shoulders, turn your knees, move your toes. So one more time, watch. Head to the left, shoulders up, knees to the left. Grab, pull, move your toes. One more time, because this is a little tricky. So you step up, step, step up, head, shoulders, knees, and toes. After that, you point your right foot, you punch your left, your right hand down. 1, 2, 3. Again, arms go up on the fourth one. You hold here until the word eyes. Then you flick your eyes to the right. You hold again until the
woo woo, and you go. Walk forward, star jump, down. After this is where you get vocal, which is kind of awkward because there are only two of us. It says Thriller, and you go scream, scream, in whatever ways you want with really big arms. So let's go over the second chorus. The back. Hey. Crazy lady. Grab, punch, 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 and down. Step up. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Point, switch, switch, hold. Eyes, hold. Okay. So after the jump down, you hold for a second, and when it says Thriller, Thriller, you scream. I'm sorry, I cut that off slightly early. We will run that again full out at the end and to make sure it makes sense, but you just go scream, scream. After that, it is the circle walks. So you go down after your screams, you pull up slowly, and then we do the same walks we did earlier, but longer and slower. You walk one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, look back, eight. Eight to the back. Four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight turning around to the front. Six, seven, look, eight, one. Eight more to the front. And then we go back to the beginning. Well, not the beginning, but the same section. Up, down, 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 head. Lift, two, three, four. Plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp and shoulders in, head. Plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp and shoulders in, head. Then you do the swings. Five, six, seven, jump, swing. Five, six, seven, jump, circles. Hit, one, two, three. Crazy lady. Grab, punch, punch, punch. Down. You do the second chorus all over again. Step, step. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Go, punch. Two, three. Hold. Hit, hit. Walk forward. Big X down, scream, scream. Then you come down and you roll up just like we did last time, but instead of doing the walks, you go back to the first chorus. One, two, three, point. One, two, three, swing, walk. Swing, walk. Swing, swing, jump. Circle, Thriller. Walk around, look, walk to the back. We're gonna go through that from the first time of the second chorus all the way to there. It is all repetition, it's just about knowing what comes next.
Oh.
Okay, this is the part where it gets very easy. We go straight back to the very, very beginning. When we do the four walks forward, four walks back, four walks forward, four walks back, the 1, 5, 7 walks forward and back, all the way through this, head down, circles, circles, lift head up, jump, jump down, lift 1, 2, 3, 4, plie, clap, shimmy, 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 stomp in, shoulder and head. You know this by now, stomp in, shoulder and head. This is where things get slightly different. We go into our walks. Let me just check which walks. It's the 1, 2, 3 walks. Great. So you jump to the walks that we used after the first chorus. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Back. 1, 2, 3. Back. 1, 2, 3. Then it's the same 4 walks forward, 4 walks back, 4 walks forward. 4 walks back, then you do the 8 circle, 8 back, 8 circle, 8 front. Then you scream and that's the end. So I'm going to say that one more time because the ending gets a little confusing, but it is just walks and it is very, very simple. We'll do it once from the second chorus, the last chorus, all the way through the end. But all you do is go back to the beginning. After you finish the stomp in shoulder and head, you do your 1, 2, 3 walks. Forward and back. Then you do the normal slow walks, forward and back. Then you do the 8 in a circle, 8 to the back, 8 in a circle, 8 to the front. Scream, big ending pose, and we are done.
Cattle Dog Cookie Company, based in Issaquah, been around for 3 years, and we make treats that use no artificial ingredients. They're handmade, human-grade ingredients. Dogs go nuts for these things. So if you try them, your dog will tell you that himself.
Now, so I have to warn you, most of this dance is freestyle. That means that you will be doing your own dance moves. Well, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna learn the chorus now. So it starts off, the chorus goes, let's do the time warp again. So your arms are gonna go, let's do the time
warp, you wrapping your arms, and then on again, your arms are gonna come up and you're gonna shimmy all the way down, and that's on again. And then it says that twice, so you repeat it. Let's do the time warp again. And then the lyrics right after that pretty much tell you all the dance moves you need to do. So it's gonna say, it's just a jump to the left. So you're gonna jump to the left and then a step to the right. This one's a little bit trickier. You're gonna get your kind of like your thriller hands that we just did and you're gonna go swish to the side like this. As you do that, your right foot is going to tap in and out. So when your arms go out, your leg goes out. You're gonna do that four times. So we go one, two, three, four, and that's gonna be on step to the right. The next lyric is you put your hands on your hips, put your hands on your hips, and then you bring your knees in tight, meaning you buckle your knees so your feet are remaining apart, but your knees are in together. If this hurts your knees, you can go ahead and just bring your feet in closer. And then the next part is the pelvic thrust. So you're gonna remain in this position, and all you're gonna do is you're going to tilt your pelvis forward four times. So we go one, two, three, four. The next part is you're going to move your hips in a little circle, but you're going to bounce them. So we're gonna start and we're gonna go bounce, 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 bounce. That is about eight times, but again, it doesn't really matter how many times you do that. So let's review from the beginning. We go, let's do the time warp again. We repeat that, arm, arm, wrap, wrap, and shimmy. We jump to the left and step to the right. Two, three, four. We put our arms on our hips and we bring our knees in tight and then we do our pelvic thrust four times. Two and three and four. We go in a circle. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, let's do that with the music. So, in the beginning is going to be a freestyle, meaning you can do whatever you want until we get to the very first chorus, which is a little bit into the song. So if you feel like you're dancing by yourself for an awkward amount of time, that is okay. There are pretty large verse gaps in this dance. And I can just go ahead and show you a couple of moves that you can incorporate. So any sort of step touch, that would be good. Go forward. Any sort of funky arms like my friend Zena is showing.
Takes its toll.
Anything shimmy.
Not for very much longer.
Just pretend you're at a party. Arm, arm, wrap, wrap, again.
It's just a jump to the left.
Open, open, open. Hands on your hips. And bring your knees in. One, two, three, four. Around. Now we repeat. Arm, arm. Open. Okay, sorry guys, so after you finish your hips in a circle, we are going to repeat, let's do the time warp again. And that phrase repeats twice every time it pops up. So every time you do this, you're gonna be doing it twice. So that whole phrase is what I like to call the full phrase. So there are three choruses in that song, meaning there are three times when this move pops up. The very first time, you're going to go all the way through. You do two of these. We do our jump to the left, our right, all of this through the hip circle, back through our arms again. The second chorus is a bit shorter. You're only going to do arm, arm, wrap, wrap, shimmy. Again, arm, arm, wrap, wrap, shimmy. So the second chorus, you do not do the jump or the step or the circle. The third chorus, we go back to the very original longer phrase. That is when we do the time warp. We also do our jump, our leg, and our hip circle. So it's kind of like a sandwich. You have the long version, the short version, and then the long version again, and then the song ends.
My name is Claude Blumensweig, and I'm the owner of Vino Bella Wine Bar down here in Issaquah, downtown Old Issaquah. And basically, we started out in 2006, October of 2006, opened up my business, and with the support of the community, and the support of the BIA, and the support of the chamber, the support of the city, everything has worked out so well for me. We've been here now 14 years, and let's keep it going with this. I've been here on pretty much all the zombie walks that we've had down here. And as you can see, all the zombies behind me there. Kind of pretty cool thing that they do. They do a lot of different things downtown Issaquah. They have the art walk, they have the wine walk, the zombie walk, and a whole bunch of other activities. They helped us with this new thing, this new program with the streetery, and that's actually been helping us a lot through our business in this time, this hard time.
I'm the general manager down here at Stan's Barbecue in lovely Issaquah. We are well known for our Kansas City style barbecue. Sauce on the side, dry rub, hickory smoked, melts in your mouth, deliciousness. And I'm out here today supporting the Zombie Walk in Issaquah that we host every year. We will be particularly doing $1 meatballs, which we're gonna call eyeballs for the event. And then of course we do $3 wells and some other drink specials. Feel free to come on in or drag yourself in during the event. We look forward to having you guys.
Chance against the thing with a 40.
the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighborhood. And whosoever shall be found without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell. Stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.
Thank you, Glasshouse Dancers. Issaquah Zombie Walk always appreciates you being a part of the event each year, especially this year during
Home Edition.
We here at the Issaquah Zombie Walk want to thank Stephen for his video submission for the Home Edition. Full video can be seen at the Issaquah Zombie Walk Facebook page. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you for joining us tonight for Issaquah Zombie Walk Home Edition. We hope to see you next year, living dead in zombie form, here on the steps of City Hall. From downtown Issaquah, I'm Shan Stev. And you know what I say? I say, be better at life. Good night.